right, we finally made it to the Rocky Mountain National Park. Jake and I got here last night and got up this morning and have been working with the rangers to make a slight adjustment to our permit, but we're all set. We're on the trail for the next 5 nights, 6 days. Gonna get up and get up over the Continental Divide a couple times, which is gonna be exciting. And so just gonna enjoy what is a beautiful national park. So I was, as always, photos and videos to come along so you can enjoy the journey.
All right, see you guys.
Same sky, same clouds, same dirt, the same ground we all live and die. The same song, the same beat, the same car, the same street we run down our dreams on.
And it is the mid-afternoon, and you can hear the thunder roaring in the background. It's been like that all day almost, or at least for the last several hours. And we are climbing towards our campsite. And we're both feeling, we didn't sleep really at all last night, so we're running on fumes to begin with. And now with the altitude and elevation gain, we're feeling it. So keep pushing on, I guess.
Sun up to sunset, we're lovers and leavers.
What's up, everyone? This is Nate and I here. We're on our first night at Rocky Mountain National Park. You can see we're at our campground here. We have our tent set up in the back. We just had dinner. We had kind of a long day today. We did 10 miles, veered off of our path for a small bit, but we got back on. We were able to see Moose and her baby calf, and yeah, that's about it. We're just chilling right now, getting ready to call it a night. I think we have another big day tomorrow of around like 10 miles or so. So
cool.
Stop me since I was 18.
just finished up the end of day two. We got up real early this morning and climbed about 3,000 feet up over 12,000 feet. So kind of tippy top of our trip this morning. And so we got a really cool experience with three bull elk on the way up. And got to spend, I don't know, 20 minutes to sort of watch them up close and interact with them, which was really cool to see them early this morning. And then got treated to really some great views as we crossed over the Continental Divide and down the other side, which then we made our way here to camp. So just finished up dinner. As you can see, the sun is quickly setting behind us, and we are getting ready for bed. So tomorrow is going to be another promising day of good weather and good trail. So it was a enjoyable second day.
Yeah, it was.
With a lot of climbing and a lot of elevation gain, but it was still a lot of fun.
It's 9:08. We getting kind of late, so we open up our eyes and say, amen,
amen,
for the life, the love, the spirit. Jesus, Allah, Krishna, Buddha, whatever name you like to say. Please grant your heavenly love and sweet peace to the family of Jessica Jo May. 6 years ago, she wrote me and said she was my biggest fan, and she wouldn't go to sleep if I didn't hit her back. So I said, thanks, boo. Go to sleep, you got school. A friendship started, but ended too soon, just a child. She used to tweet me every day, draw me little pictures, say I hope you feel okay. I bet she never knew that I was going through some shit. My family was pissed at me and I almost quit on that November night, till I saw what she tweeted. Keep making good music, that was just what I needed. You know I never even told her thank you, and I don't know why. Cause on August 26th, Jessica died. I never thought that some fan on Twitter would give me a broken heart, but Lord, I miss her. When you opening the gates up, don't forget her, and save me a spot, soon I'll be right there with her. Amen,
amen,
for the life, the love, the spirit.
All right, what's up, guys? We just got to Fern Lake, our Fern Lake campsite, a little bit ago. We set up our camp, here, getting ready to cook dinner. We hiked from Upper Mill Creek. It was about a 10-mile day. We added on a few extra miles. We wanted to see Moraine Park, which is like this big open grass area, which was really pretty. We sat there for about an hour and had lunch and talked, and then we went on our way. So Fern Lake is just on the other side of the camera there. It's really pretty. We have some rain clouds, I think, rolling in right now, but we'll cook dinner here before, hopefully, and be on our way.
Breeze off the pond, our trees on the lawn. Wind is always there, they're saying it's just there. Let it blow through you. Thank you.
lost the sparkling wings.
No, that was weird. All right, well, we are done with day four.
Day four.
We got up at 4 a.m. this morning. We had 14 miles on the trail today with a couple big climbs, so we got up early so we could get it before the sun was frying us. And, yeah, so it was our longest and hardest day, but also maybe the most rewarding. We had some really incredible views and came across two bull moose, which was something that we had both said we wanted to try to see while we were here, so super excited by that. You probably can't see in the background. There you go, maybe. Got this creek run through and the mountains behind us.
Just had dinner.
Yeah, just had dinner here, and gonna hang out for a while and maybe do a little star photography tonight. Yeah, so looking forward. So tomorrow's our last full day here in the park. And it's been a blast so far.
I need an altitude adjustment. Get higher and higher until I feel nothing. Pure mountain air, good clean love. And I need an altitude adjustment. Jammed up again in the music city. Damn, I'm gonna sit here and write your days. I'm backing up my six.
All right, what's up, everyone? We're walking back from getting water. We got to our campsite earlier today. We hiked from Sunrise Campsite to Summerlin Park Campsite. It's about 7.5 mile hike, and we're on our last night here in Rocky Mountain National Park, so had a blast. I think we're both sad to say it's our last night here, but we will probably have an early morning tomorrow to get out of here and catch our flights. So, all right, we'll see you later.
All right, well, it's coming to an end. Our 6 day, 5 night adventure through the Rocky Mountain National Park. You know, we covered almost 60 miles, climbed thousands and thousands of feet of elevation, saw lots of cool animals and amazing views. But Jake, what was your highlight moment?
Highlight moment for me would probably be the hike up Flat Top Mountain the second time. It was just super challenging, a lot of elevation and a short distance, but the views and the, you know, sense of accomplishment that I felt at the top was definitely something to be said for. So that was probably my highlight.
Yeah, no, that was a good climb, and the view up there is pretty spectacular. Also, like, quite windy.
Yes, yeah. Like, second day was very windy.
Like, blow you over.
It was not at our back either.
No, like, right in the face. Yeah, I think maybe I just shortly after that we jumped back on the CDT and headed sort of downward, and as we kind of went down, we had this great view into the mountains and meadows below us. So that's a view that will stick with me, that was really mesmerizing to kind of be able to walk into. And then secondly, yeah, is just the animals. You know, we've gotten up close and personal with a moose.
Yeah.
Like half hour ago.
Yeah, almost within arm's reach.
Yeah, like right there. And elk. I mean, we were within, a handful of feet of some elk. So,
yeah.
It's a kind of unique experience when you can do that and try to do it safely and responsibly, but that's part of coming out into the outdoors. So, yep. Overall, a really great trip. The weather, couldn't have been much better. We got some rain, but really, it has worked out for us well. And an enjoyable time with Jake to hike all these miles and have good conversation and enjoy each other's company. So thanks for following along, and hopefully the videos and the photos give you a sense of what it's like to spend a week almost here in the park. Thanks. See you guys.